day, ladies and gentlemen. Today we are continuing our discussion on 303 British, and the subject up for discussion today is reloading Burdon primed cases. Unfortunately, in the past, a lot of people told us, that these cases are not worth much. You cannot reload them. You can't do much with them. So way back, a lot of us shot a lot of these rounds, and we just chucked the cases. Unfortunately, I now figured out that it's not so difficult to deprime them and to reload them. Let me just give you a few hints. So what I do is I use a number 5 shell holder. It's a Lee hand priming tool shell holder. You'll see it looks a bit different from the normal shell holder that goes into the die press. It's flat at the bottom here, no extruded bit at the bottom, which makes it easy to use for the following purpose as well. So what I do is I use an 8mm screwdriver. Phillips screwdriver makes it much easier because it's a Phillips. It has a sharper point and it enters the case easily. It's an 8mm in diameter, 8mm screwdriver. So the fact that it's an 8mm allows it to fit snugly in a fired case. So when a case is fired, it will not fit into a resized case, but when it's fired, it expands to fit the chamber and to allow the bullet to exit. Therefore, this works quite well. So what I do, I'm not going to show you here now because it will waste a lot of water and mess a bit, and then maybe get the camera all wet. But I fill this with water, and then I fit the screwdriver in like that, and on top you basically just hit it on top with a rubber mallet or plastic mallet. Wooden mallet can work as well. It creates hydraulic effect, hydraulic pressure in here, and the primer pops out at the bottom. When you do it for the first time, it's not all of them are easy because of the military crimp that was done on the Burdon primer. So some of them are also even glued with some sort of lacquer to seal it and to fit more tightly into the primer pocket. So they don't all come out as easily. But when you do it the second and third time, it's actually very quick and very easy. So now that you have deprimed the cases, you will see that it's a Burdon primer. It's got a double hole in there. Let me hold it against the light here. Different from a normal boxer primer, with a single flash hole. This has got two flash holes, double flash hole. Now the next step would be to deburr, to get rid of that military crimp lugs there. And what you're going to do, you would use this little Lee tool again. It is the same tool you use to chamfer and deburr the case mouth. So you basically, the angle of the shoulder here is steep enough not to damage the anvil of the primer pocket inside. So you just deburr it there and you chafe the crimp groove off. so that the primer fits in snugly and you can deprime it easier the next time around. The next step would be to full length resize these cases. Seeing that you have now put some pressure on them, you could have deformed the neck and the mouth a little bit with a screwdriver and the hydraulic pressure. So I use a Redding full length resizing die in order to resize these cases. You will see, let me show you, that in the resizing die the decapping pin has been removed. With the Redding dies you can actually remove the decapping pin. When you unscrew the parts and take it apart, you loosen the expander ball and you take out the decapping pin. You definitely have to remove your decapping pin, because the decapping pin would go straight down into the middle of the case and it would get damaged, and it would even damage your case. There is the decapping pin that I've removed. So after that's done and you've now trimmed your case and brushed it out, I've cleaned it with a sonic cleaner, so it's clean now. Now we can reload it. You will see the anvil in the case there. That is what makes it different from boxer primed cases. Boxer primers has got their own anvil built into the primer, whereas bad unprimed cases, they've got the anvil in the case. And here I've got Burden primers. They are not that easy to come by, but luckily here in South Africa we can still buy them, and therefore it's quite easy to recycle these cases and use them again and again. The next step would then be to trim the cases to the required length and to a uniform length, all of them. So to do that, you cannot use the normal Lee case trimming device, because that one actually pushes through the flash hole. It's got a little guide that pushes through the flash hole. So therefore I use this Lee case trimmer, a quick trim. So this is the die that I use. Let me just fit it into my Hornady lock and load here. Let's put the case in, and case fits in nicely. You lift it into the die there, and then you use this device, the other part of the quick trim case trimmer with the blades in there. You fit it in there and you push it down and turn it, and this will easily trim the case to length. This specific tool also has blades in there. You will see that actually deburrs and chamfers the case as well, but if it doesn't do it to the right amount that you require, you simply use this deburring and chamfering tool again to get your case to requirement. What I did next as a next step was, you know, to brush, to clean it out, basically get the soot out of the cases with a brush. So when priming the Burden cases, you basically use the normal priming tool. You will see a Burden primer is a little bit bigger than the normal boxer primer, but it does fit. This is a Hornady hand priming tool that I'm using. It works just like you would normally prime a boxer primer. Let's do one quickly. You insert it as normal. Hold it 45 degrees away from your face. Be sure to have your safety goggles on when doing this. And you basically press down on it and it seats. So this is it. There's your case. And there's your Burden primer. Seated in the case. Not much different from what you're used to. And other than this, you just proceed as normal, like you would load your cases.